turn the volume down, and let's turn down the volume, turn volume up, change songs, so it's changing songs, fast forward. So step one, what we want to do is download the Unified Remote application from Google Play. So if you go to Google Play, yeah, and you're going to search for Unified Remote. Okay, so you're going to download the free one, so click on that and install the application. Okay, now you're going to open it and click accept, and here is where it says you now need to install something on your computer. Install the latest Unified Remote server on your computer. So we're going to do that now. Okay, now that we're at www.unifiedremote.com on your PC, click on download version 2.5. And what you want to click on is the Unified Remote Server portable version. And the reason why we want the portable version is because we don't need to install that. So even if you don't have administrator permission on your computer, you can still use this program. So click on that. And notice how on the bottom left you have a zip file. Okay, now you're gonna open it up. Unified Remote Portable, you're gonna extract it. Okay, and what you wanna do is double click on remoteserver.exe. And you will see that on the bottom right hand corner, the Unified Remote has showed up here, and it is now running on the bottom right hand corner. Okay, the next step is to connect your laptop to your phone via Bluetooth. And what you want to do is go to the start button on the bottom left, go to devices, and then what you want to do is right click on your computer or laptop and go to Bluetooth settings. Click on allow Bluetooth devices to find your computer. Show the Bluetooth icon, allow Bluetooth devices to connect, alert me when a new Bluetooth device wants to connect. And you're going to click OK. So on the bottom right hand corner, you will now see a Bluetooth device icon here. Okay, now we're going to go back to our phone and try to find the computer to connect to it. Okay, now back to your phone, you want to click on I have installed the new server. Make sure that Unified Remote is running on your PC. Also ensure that Windows Firewall or any other software is not blocking your server. Okay, now what we want to do is make sure that our phone is connected to the computer via Bluetooth before we scan for any service. So back to our main menu, you're going to turn off the wireless. You're going to turn off the wireless connection, which is that one, and you're going to turn off the automatic sync And what you want to do is turn on Bluetooth. So that is the Bluetooth icon. Keep in mind that I'm currently on Cyanogen Mod 7, so you might do this differently if you have another operating system. Okay, so now that our Bluetooth is turned on, we're gonna go to Bluetooth settings. So go into settings, wireless network settings, Bluetooth settings. We're going to make our device discoverable, and we're gonna scan for devices, and you can see that it's found my computer here, so I'm gonna pair with this device. Type PIN to pair with the device. So what I'm going to do is just type in 1234 and then you're going to click OK. Back to our computer, I've just received a message saying a Bluetooth device is trying to connect, so we're going to click to allow this and we're going to type in 1234 again. So click next. And now it's connected to our computer, the phone. So close. Okay, now that the phone is connected to our computer via Bluetooth, and make sure that the remote server is running. Unified remote server, make sure that it's still running. And now we should be able to, and make sure you go into connections and make sure it's accepting Bluetooth connections. And now we should be able to go to our phone and scan for the computer to connect to. Okay, so back to our phone. We're gonna go to our Unified Remote program, and now we can scan for servers. Make sure your wireless is not turned on but your Bluetooth is, otherwise it'll connect to your computer via wireless. So click next, 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 finish, oops, go back to it. Okay, so we're gonna click on servers and we're gonna click add and we're gonna click automatic, and you can see that it's found our computer there. So click on my computer name. Now that the computer has been added to the server, you should be able to go to remotes. Notice how it is syncing. Okay, now you're gonna click basic input. So if you have a look at my computer screen, I'm moving my mouse using my phone. So what I have just done is open up VLC Player, and I want to show you that I can use my phone as a remote to change songs on the computer. So back on our phone, we want to go to the scroll down to VLC remote. Okay, and now we're going to click play. So you can see my laptop is playing the music. Turn the volume down.